Hi folks, I'm Tyler France from Natural Pursuit Outdoors. This is my debut camera experience here, coming straight to you from Pennsylvania. Natural Pursuit Outdoors, we're real sportsmen, wild game, playing by nature's rules. This is our passion. This is what we do. Right now I'm gearing up for an opportunity to go out and do some spring gobbler hunting with the bow. Fellow pro staffer, Bobby Wolfgang, and myself are geared up, and we're going to try to go out and get some footage of some archery groundhog hunting. And this August, late summer, I'm heading to Wyoming, and I'm going to try to take a pronghorn with archery tackle. So what I'm going to do today is some backyard practice, just to make sure that my bow's tuned up and I'm staying sharp. Stay with us. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to be out here taking a couple shots, making sure that my skills are honed. It's May the 1st, and I think that year-round practice is a good thing to do. I know that time's limited. I know I got a busy schedule, just as I'm sure many other outdoorsmen do, but we gotta stay at it. We owe it to the animals that we pursue to keep our skills sharp. So I'm gonna do a little practice here, and hopefully I'm shooting as good as I was shooting in the fall. First shot, not too bad. Let's take a look at it. Not bad. I'm gonna keep the camera here set on the target so that I can see how my shots are being placed. One thing I want to talk about here, I want to share with you a little contraption I came up with. It's my little mobile arrow holder here. I just simply took a piece of PVC pipe, attached a piece of wood to the bottom, ran rope through the top, and have a mobile handle on it so I could take this around. When I come back, I simply throw my arrows in there and I have a nice holder. It's convenient. I could take this with me to retrieve my arrows, and then when I bring it back, I have them here ready to go at an easy hand. As I said earlier, the Natural Pursuit team aims to put together a groundhog hunting video this summer. This is something that pro staffer Bobby Wolfgang and myself have done for years when we were kids, you know, maybe 13, 14, 15 years old. We got into hunting, and we really started to get into archery hunting. And one thing to get ourselves, you know, practice up for the fall deer seasons was when we were about 15, 16 years old, we started groundhog hunting with the bow. Now if you want to talk about action, these things are sly. They got good eyesight, they're quick to run away, but when you put together some spot and stalk tactics, some techniques, and you're sneaky, you can creep into bow range and get some great shots at some of these elusive animals. This time of year they're really out foraging, grazing on the farmers' fields, and a lot of farmers are eager to give you access to go in and hunt these properties for this abundant prey. So what I did was I took a milk jug and I set up a milk jug out here at my target to simulate what a groundhog might be. All right, if a groundhog's out in the field, you know, it's eating some soybeans or some clover, and it stands up. Groundhogs often stand up. So I put out an old milk jug there, and I'm gonna see if I can't hit this milk jug to get practice up for these Pennsylvania woodchucks.
Oh yeah, baby. Looks like those woodchucks are in big trouble this summer.